us bar has too much money. That's why y'all should tune
Lady B in the basement.
8:10 each weekday morning to play that celebrity name game.
Yep, it's up to $800 at jackpot, baby.
$800 already, Touch? Y'all better tune in, get your money, and then call me and let me know.
Listen, Lady B, Luther, and George. This is like a... Okay, so I'm just unsure
as I take your hand and lead it to the dance floor. As the music dies, something in your eyes calls to mind a silver screen. You know it's sad.
Alright, that was a distraction.
Guilty feet have got no rhythm, though it's easy to pretend. I know you're not a fool. Should've known better than to cheat a friend and waste the chance that I've been given. Though I'm never gonna dance again the way I danced with you.
Yeah, you're not. That's true. Okay, I'm gonna turn this down. Because what I'm sharing about actually is the first time I ever really realized, and by realized I mean it landed like bricks in my body, right? Like an understanding of boom. But I didn't have the words for it yet. I was a young adult, I don't know, late teens, early 20s, and I watched Purple Rain. Okay, this is a spoiler alert. So, you know, like tears were just streaming down my face. I mean, I had never, ever, ever cried like that for a movie, at least, or any kind of art ever. And it was like streaming tears rolling down my face onto my shirt. I couldn't believe it. And I was so moved, and I think, you know, having more language now than I did then, what was happening was me realizing that it wasn't just me. It wasn't just me that knew, or that experienced, I should say, that experienced love being intertwined like a freaking telephone cord that was completely tangled. You know, the ones from the 80s, like those curly ones, totally entangled. I mean, wrapped up, like you'd have to spend some time untangling them. Love with pain, love with really shitty behavior, love with behavior that felt like hate, love with behavior that felt like trauma. Well, not that that was a word then, but love with pain, like abuse. That's it. That's the word. And I realized, and then it's not that I had these words. These words are later, but I realized as I was bawling my eyeballs out, I'm not the only one that is experiencing love as abuse. Yeah, that's it. And that's the words I'm translating for my 18-year-old self or my 20-year-old self, but that's the words. And when you watch how Prince's character in that movie, Prince's character is named the Kid, but it's like based on Prince. I think I've read that several places, but so his character, the Kid, he has like a meltdown, right? First he witnesses his father, spoiler alert, don't cry about this if you didn't watch it and you want to watch it, stop here. He watches his father try to commit suicide. And he spirals. Well, first, his mother, you know, who you wouldn't expect to be so upset because she's like at the end of his abuse so much. She's at the hand of his abuse so much. You would expect, you wouldn't even be surprised if she was like good. Only that strong. But anyway, she's crying. She's hysterical. And then, so there's a montage. And, you know, the cops are there and this and that. And then there's a montage of the PTSD. Like, the overload. His sensory overload. His nervous system just breaks. And he has all these flashbacks. And there's the outline of the gun, like in chalk, and it keeps cutting away to the, to this rope. So the implication is like, he's gonna commit suicide too. And, you wouldn't be surprised if he did, right? Like, this is part of what I teach, what I heal. The nervous system, yes, individually, but also the nervous system of our ancestors. This shit comes down in our blood. So, you know, suicide will repeat, stillbirths will repeat, divorces will repeat, you name it, it will repeat until the cycle breaker breaks it. And guess what? Being the cycle breaker sucks. It's not like, hey, pick me. It's not it. But if that's, you know, if that's what your mission is, that's what your mission is. So, okay. So Prince/the kid, just starts smashing stuff. And instead of taking that self-destruction inward, like so many of us do, understandably so, instead of like drugging or drinking or pornoing or, whatever, you name it, gambling, insert quote-unquote vice here, he expresses it instead of internalizes it. So he starts just smashing everything in the basement, all the jars of food, and just tearing everything down, throwing the cabinets down, just tearing it up, right? So that's good, that's great. Actually, the outburst, it's an outburst instead of an inburst. And so he lands in sheets of music. He lands in the magic of his ancestry. He lands in the gifts of his ancestry. He lands in Francis L's majesty. And as the family alchemist he is, as I am, and perhaps you are, as the family alchemist he is, he sits at that piano and he makes it mean something different. And that is the work that we're doing. We have carried this long enough. And if you're interested and inspired in upgrading and up-leveling any trauma, it doesn't need to be that serious or severe. And it just needs to be something that you want to change. I invite you wholeheartedly to join me on my webinar, Suffering Obligations of Love, and go exploring with me, because there's so much magic here and it's time. And as that, I think it's Hopi Indian saying goes, we are the ones we've been waiting for. We are the ones we've been waiting for. So join me. The link, I'm going to paste it and post it below. And I hope to see you there. November 2nd, 7:30 Eastern Time. Okay. Have a beautiful rest of your day. Ciao.